of a time, there was a wharf who called William Wharf, the huge happy wharf. He had a good family, a good home, and a good job at the best business. One day, as he went to his work, three shadow figure crawled up toward his home. And when he back home, he saw his house completely wrecked. As he entered his home, he saw a huge claw mark scratch across the wall that was bigger than his. As he entered further into the house, he saw something that horrified him the most. It was his family, dead body on the floor, where his wife's skin was missing and his daughter's head was missing. William was so heartbroken, he fell on his knee and soaking in his pain. Then two sheep appeared behind him while pointing at him with a gun and said,
"You are under arrest for murdering.
And the wolf replied, I didn't do any of this. I just got here before this happened." However, the sheep said,
"Tell that to the judge."
At the start of the court, before the wolf has the chance to say, "Your worship, I..." Then the judge, who was a goat, butted in and said, "This wolf is nothing but the work of a savage beast. He is hereby guilty of the murder. And I sentence this thing for life imprisonment." A wolf shouted, "Hang on a sec! I haven't had the chance to prove my innocence yet, you old goat!" Before he was taken away by sheep. 10 years later, in prison, the wolf sat against the cold wall in the dark as he felt nothing but sadness. But the sheep appeared and said,
"Hey, Fumble, you had three visitors."
So the wolf moved slowly toward the bar. There he saw was the free little piggy from his neighborhood. Just came to him to say hello. And the wolf believed they are the only hope they could have the witness in the scene. He pleased them to stop to tell the cop what actually happened. But the pig in a smart suit said,
"That would be already too late for that."
What are you talking about?" cried the wolf.
"Do you know they are going to execute you in the next 10 days?
Said the pig.
You have to stop them doing it," said the wolf.
"Oh, we could do that, but it would be more hilarious to hear what sound you will make as you sit in that chair, and we wonder if it could be the same sound as your wife,"
said the pig. "What do you mean, my wife?" said the wolf. The pig whispered in the wolf's ear,
"Your wife? How really funny as we skin her alive,"
said the pig with a grin.
You did it?
Why? Said the wolf, who sounded just like a broken toy.
"For sport, of course. They make fine trophy to hang on my wall. And it's no use for you telling anyone about your crime, because you're a wolf, a disgusting wild wolf, and nobody would
never believe an animal the like of you, said the pig. His word hit him so hard, it made the light in his eye become black as he tried to claw him to death from behind him. Well, while he said, I will kill you! I swear to God, I will kill you and send you to hell! And then the pig yelled,
please help! This aggressive wolf tried to kill me!
Then the sheep came in and beat the wolf up with a bat. The pig said to the cop,
I demand you to put this thing down tonight!
As he handed the sheep a huge sum of money to them, and the cop said,
no, Blablan, I will see what I can do about it.
As the sheep and the pig left, the wolf felt against the bar as his soul of light in his eye had gone and become the eyes of burning rage. He broke free from the prison. You murder my family for your sick fun game because they are wolves, and you know what wolves are really like when they are angry. I will show you what happened to wolves when they are really angry to make you wish you never crossed our path, and you better bolt your door at night.